Good morning everyone, myself Patel ma'am from SGM College Karad. I'm going to teach you to you the subject OCM. Okay, as last lecture we have started with a new chapter, the first chapter in the OCM, that was the nature and scope of business. In the last lecture I have given a brief explanation and an introduction of the chapter, the nature and scope of business. First I have said about the introduction, then I have drawn a diagram. In that was human activities, which were divided into two parts: economic activities, non-economic activities. Economic activities were further divided into three parts: business, profession, employment. And I said you that today I am going to teach to you first point of economic activity, which is business. First I'll say about the meaning of the business, and then I'll say about the definition, and then I'll move ahead with the next point, features. Okay, so we know very well about the business. You have from the childhood also you have listened to the word business. Okay, what do you mean by a business? What do you mean by a trader? What activities are done in the business, and what are the main important features of the business? We will see here into detail. So business represent or organized efforts by an individual or group of individuals. What is business? Business is always representing what? Organized efforts by an individual. When an individual has become a businessman, he puts all his efforts in that. Yes or no? Like common man who haven't started a common thing, with a common thing, that is what? That is a business. When he starts a business, he puts all the efforts in the business. Why? See, when a business is started, at that time, first of all, you collect all the money, you invest into your business. That is said as a capital of the business. And when you invest into the business, you put your all efforts, organized efforts in that. Why? Why you put on that? Because you want to earn a profit. You are going to provide goods and services to the common customer, consumer, but you will get something in return of that, and that return will be said as a profit only. So a business is a systematic attempt by business person to produce goods and services and to sell into the market. What is business? Business is a systematic attempt which is going to done by whom? Which is going to done by the business person. Why? Because see, a common businessman always produces goods. When you do the production, see, it's not like that every businessman will be relate with the production. Some businessman will do what? Will do the production of good. Some will do the distribution of good. Yes or no? That means what? Production and distribution is a two important point that you should know when you are relating with the business. So it is a systematic attempt by the business person when they do production of goods and services and sell them into the market to reap the reward in the way of a profit. Yes or no? That means when I'm doing production, when I'm doing selling the goods in the market, at that time I get in return something, and that is what? That is the profit for the business. So it satisfies multiple and complex need of the society. Always remember, various needs are there in the society. As I have given you a brief explanation in the last lecture about the customer need, customer satisfaction. Customers' needs are there, satisfactions are there, that is to be provided. And to provide all these things, you need the proper way. And for that, every time the businessman is helping the society by providing goods and services to the common customer or consumer. So, production of goods actually means making of goods. Yes or no? You, as I said, you see, two levels are there in the business. First is production. Production means to collect, understand the concept. Production means to collect all the raw material, and that raw material converted into the finished product. Yes or no? Like you, when mother wants to cook something, at that time first she bring all the vegetables, clean the vegetable, cut the vegetable, then she make the proper whatever is vegetable she want to make, whatever dinner or lunch she want to make. Okay, just like that, collection of the raw material, that raw material converting into the finished product is always done in the production level. When the goods are produced, then it is distributed to you in the common market, and common consumer like us, we purchase. Okay, so production of the good actually means the making of good. It may be agricultural product or finished product produced in the factory. Now, sometime agricultural products are there now, which are produced where? Tell me, agricultural production is done where? In the field. When the farmer do farming, like about what? Wheat, jowar, bajra, yes or no? Planting for various types of trees to get fruits, vegetables. When this is done, at that time only agriculture products come. So it may be any product. It may be either agricultural product or it may be any of the finished product. Finished product means when it comes in the market. Or finished product produced in the market. Goods can be produced with the manpower or with the help of machine. Yes or no? Like manpower, like what? Only men are producing. Men means not men. Men or women, not. Men means common man. Common, it may be a man or it may be a woman. So machine means when goods are made by machine. You will say the goods are produced through machine power. When goods are made by men, you will say goods are made by men. Yes or no? So goods may be produced by both men also, machine power also. Okay, example is given. Cultivating a piece of land and growing food grain is an example of agriculture production. Yes or no? When a farmer sow a seed into the field and from that it comes. And when it cultivation in the farming, at that time what come is agriculture production. Then another example is, however, converting oil seed into edible oil with the help of men as well as machine power is an example of manufacturing of good. Correct it is. See, oil seed, I know it comes from where? It comes from the field only. Yes or no? But that oil seed only. See, oil seed come from the field. That means which power? Manpower. But that oil seed, when it is brought into the factory and converted into the edible oil, which we eat in our daily vegetables one. Edible oil, that is done by machine power. That means what we need for goods. Manpower also, machine power also. Okay, so that is related with the production and distribution of goods and services through various types of a power, like a manpower and a machine power. Okay, so not only this is it. With that, you need what? You need distribution, which include marketing of good and services. So just this is not enough. Oil seed is there somewhere in the one of the farm where farmer is doing. That seed has to be bring where? In the factory. For that, what is needed? Transportation. Yes or no? That is converted into the factory into edible oil. Then it is bought in the market. Then it is done. Marketing is done. That means transportation, marketing, warehousing, advertising, all are done in this afterward process. So it include all those things as a part of a business only, and transfer of goods from producer to the final consumer is a main motive of the business. That means I as a producer, I as a businessman, I am producing, I am converting into finished product from, it may be from agricultural product to the common product, okay? But afterwards it comes where? To the final customer. That means the final destination is you, is we, that when we purchase from the producer, wholesaler or any retailer, or from the market, when we purchase, that will be the last destination. That means the consumer. Got it, everyone? That is said as a meaning of a business, which I gave you a brief explanation. Got? The next is a definition. Now definition is put forth by two persons. The first is the Professor Haney. First is given by Professor Haney. What Haney says, let's see. And the second definition is put forth by Professor Hugs and Kapoor. You will say, I like Kapoor only. Okay, so let's start now further. The definition is put forth by two. First is put forth by Professor Haney. Haney says, business activities are all those human activities which are directed toward the production and processes of wealth. Correct it is. What Haney say? That all the business activities are all those human activities. That means business activities are human activities only which are directed toward the production and processing wealth. That means production is done and with the help of that earning profit is there. That means processing wealth. Then Hugs and Kapoor, Professor Hugs and Kapoor says what? The organized effort of individual to produce and sell for a profit the goods and services that society, that satisfy society need. Kapoor also said correctly, because always the production is done, why? To fulfill the need of the customer, to fulfill the satisfaction level of the customer, and with that all the efforts of production and selling are what? To earn a profit, and these goods and services always satisfy the needs. Got it? So two definition was there. First definition was put forth by Hani and second definition was put forth by Professor Hugs and Kapoor. Got it? Let's move on ahead. The next afterwards which we will see now is the features of the business. Okay? Let's see further. Further we will see now is the features of business. Features of business is divided into 10 points. One by one we will see. First, it is an economic activity. First is what? An economic activity. First is said it is an economic activity. Second, it is said every time two parties are there. Okay? Let's see first one. First, you all know very well, and I have said you many a time, when you say a word business, it is obviously an economic activity only. Business is an economic activity as it is undertaken to earn money or livelihood. Yes or no? Why business is done? Business is done to earn a profit. Production is done to sell the good, and from the selling, profit comes. So always remember, business is an economic activity and it is undertaken, why? To earn a money, to earn a profit. It is not because of love, affection, feelings, sentiments, etc. Of course, yes, love, affection, feelings, sentiment comes in non-economic activity. Yes or no? Because I feel like to your music. Yes or no? I feel very happy when I listen to the music. You see like this. Yes or no? So that means what? That is a non-economic, because you feel happy. You're satisfied. Your sentiment is related with that. But non-economic activities are done always to earn a profit. So business is obviously compulsorily an economic activity as it is undertaken to earn a money only. Got it? Number two is the two parties. Everywhere you all know, wherever you go, when you say a word business, there are two parties. One is a buyer, another is a seller. Seller sell the goods, buyer purchase the good. This is the common one. So every business transaction involves an exchange. Okay, minimum two parties are required for exchange. Yes or no? Exchange of what? Goods are there in exchange of money. Okay, so business, that is a seller and a buyer. Business transaction is a result of an arrangement between the buyer and a seller, which may be oral or written. Common, that is, you all know that your exchange is going to be there. I am going to go in a particular shop, I'll give the money, he'll give me the good. Or is it like that? I'll give money and he'll also give me money. No, he will give me good, I will also give him good. Only exchange is there of good in exchange of money. Got it, everyone? That was related to two party. Number three is what? Number three is profit motive. Number three is what? Profit motive. And number four is, that is production of goods and services. Okay? Production of goods and services. Okay, number three, as I said you many times prior also, that always whenever the business is done, the main motive is to earn a profit. Without profit, not a single person is there in the earth who will say, I'm just doing the business like that, I don't want to earn a profit. If you give me loss, it's okay. Is it like that? No. Everyone, wherever business started, main motive is to earn a profit. The basic purpose of business is to earn a profit from its activities done. Businessmen always try to maximize profit, either by increasing the volume of a sale or by reducing its cost. Yes or no? If I'm a businessman, I will work harder and harder. Why? I want to earn a profit. I'll try to maximize my profit at a very best level with the various things. Like, how I'll maximize my profit? By increasing the sale, by selling more product, or by doing what? Or reducing the cost. Okay, two important point is there. It is a spine of a business which keeps a business going on in the long term, and the amount of a profit may differ from business to business. Yes, of course, one businessman is earning more profit, another businessman is earning less profit. Yes or no? Because goods also differ, profit also differ, and businessman itself differ. And every time profit is said as a spine of the business. Yes or no? We have a spine at the back of the body which makes us to stand correct, erect. Yes or no? Just like that, when business want to stand correct, erectly, at that time always businessman should earn a profit. Number three. Number four is production of goods and services. Now, business always is an economic activity. Always main motive is to earn a profit. There are always two party, buyer and a seller, and always a business is related with the production of goods and services. Businessmen either do production of good, or either do servicing, or either do marketing, or either do the selling of a good. All is done with the business. So before exchanging the goods and services, they should be produced by the business enterprises. Goods are either manufactured or procured from the supplier with the aim of selling it further to the consumer for profit. Either the businessman do what? Himself do production, or sometime he purchase the produced good and sell it. So every time the changing situation is there. Sometime I will collect the raw material only and I'll give it to the production department. It happens like that. Then production department convert it into the finished product, and then it come to the wholesaler, then to the retailer, and then to the common customer. So every time production is there of goods and services with a various form. Businessman has to do the production, has to do the production of good. With that, services is also there. Not only to earn a profit should be the sole aim, service also you should provide. Yes or no? As I give example of this, that service is also there. Okay, that means like when you are going into the bus, always when you enter into the bus, at that time you purchase a ticket from the conductor. He give you goods in exchange of that? No, he is going to drop you to your proper destination. That means service is provided by the bus. Goods are not provided by that. So business is always related with the production of goods and services. Okay, next is exchange of goods and services. So wherever production is there, with that, exchange of goods and services is also there. Goods are exchanged with money. Services are exchanged with money. Now, which I gave you the example was what? You enter into the bus. You want to go to another destination. At that time, when you enter, you purchase a ticket and he provide you the service by just giving you a proper direction, and your destination comes towards it. That means what? Exchange is there of goods as well as services. Business involves transfer of goods and services directly or indirectly with monies or money's worth. Always remember, when business is there, exchange is there of goods and services. It may be directly also, or it may be indirectly also. Monetary exchange is the exchange with money. Like what? Common monetary exchange, I'll give you an example. You go into the shop, you purchase a book. When you purchase a book, you give money. You give what? You give money and you take what? Books. Yes or no? When you want to purchase a specific book, you give the money to the shopkeeper and he gives you the book. This is what? Monetary exchange. This is the monetary exchange which is there for cash. And on the other hand, in case of barter exchange of service are exchanged for some other good. That is what is exchange. I'll tell you one example. Barter exchange is what? Barter exchange is said as non-monetary transaction. You have in the accounts also. Barter exchange was there where? At the time of civilization, where money was not there, goods were exchanged with goods. That means always goods were exchanged with goods. Example is given, if suppose the one farmer is doing production of rice and this farmer is doing production of wheat. At that time they used to exchange wheat from rice. Money is not related. Cotton from milk. Yes or no? Rice for milk, like this. No measurement was there, nothing was there. At that time only exchange of goods with goods was there. Okay, so exchange of goods with money today we are doing monetary exchange. exchange of cash, sometime on a credit, like that. Okay? So if goods are produced for own consumption, that is stitching a dress for a daughter, it is cannot be said as a business activity, because stitching a dress in a tailoring shop and taking stitching charges is a business activity. Correct? It is. Yes or no? If your mother is a tailor, at that time she stitches the dress for herself, for daughter, for the relative. Sometimes she, for the relative, she would take money, but for herself and daughter, she'll take money, no. But for the outside party, when come into the shop, obviously she'll take money. That means that is an economic activity, and this is non-economic activity. Okay, exchange of goods are there always with the various types of the services. When goods are exchanged to goods, that is a barter exchange. Today barter exchange is there? No. Okay, next is dealing in goods and services. Number 6 is dealing in goods and services. Always production of goods and services are there, with that exchange of goods and services are there, and the goods are also deal in the goods. Okay, let's see further. Every type of the transaction are done with the main motive to earn a profit. Profit motive is a sole aim of every businessman, where two parties are included, but dealing you do in the goods as well as the services. Every type of the transaction is concerned with either goods or the services. In the absence of goods and services, business cannot take place. Just have a common thought that without goods, can you do the business? No. Without service, can you do the business? No. So always goods are divided into two parts. Goods are divided into two parts. Consumer goods, capital goods. Understand this. Goods are divided into two parts. Consumer goods, capital goods. Consumer goods are what? Tea, milk, sugar, which are day to day need and which are always being used. Capital goods are what? When you relate with machinery, plant, or you are doing various types of furniture activities, etc. Okay? So dealing in goods and services is always related with what? Relate with the various types of services which are provided. Okay, well, goods are goods, consumer goods or capital goods. Always remember two types of goods are there. Consumer goods like tea, milk, sugar, pencil, pen, eraser, like this. And capital goods are related with what? Machinery, furniture, plant, etc. Okay, every time these things you have to relate and you have to understand. That was your point number 6. Total you have in the feature 10 points. Okay, we started with the first one, economic activity, two parties, profit motive, production of goods and services, exchange of goods and services. That means you have to do production also, you have to do exchange also, and with that you have to always deal in the various type of the goods. Because when goods are not there, how you will do the dealing? You cannot do. Like when you are want to relate with money, when you want to relate with the profit, at that time you have to relate with the dealing in the goods and the services. Afterwards, now the next point which we will see is what? Continuing. Continuity in the business. Okay? So remaining part is there, that we will see in the next lecture. 6 points I teach, 4 points are left. We will continue in the next lecture. Thank you.